Hey everyone, it's Tuesday, and we're talking new games again, of course. I found a camera here. I heard rumors that if I look through the camera, I can like see the games like in real life. Isn't that crazy? So we're gonna try it out and see what happens.
The top game of the week is Fatal Frame, Mask of the Lunar Eclipse on PC, PS4, PS5, Switch, Xbox One, and Series S and X. My God, what am I seeing here? Lord, help us. Help us all. Next, we have Paranormasite, The Seven Mysteries of Hanjo on PC and Switch. This is an adventure mystery game where players are afflicted with a curse that they must remove. What the hell is that? Oh God. Moving on, we have Caverns of Mars Recharged, coming out on PC, PS4, Switch, and Xbox One. This is a reimagining of the classic Atari game, and what the hell is that? Nope. No thank you. Our last game this week is Figment 2 Creed Valley. Figment 2 is an action-adventure game set in the human mind. You control a character named Dusty, who is actually your mind's own courage, and you go with him and take on a bunch of nightmares that have invaded your mind and are just causing you to kind of feel scared. Wait. Are these things I'm seeing just figments of my own imagination? Is my fear real? Are these things even real? What am I doing? Am I really seeing these games? Or is this all just in my mind? Is this fear real? Am I going insane?
Hey, what do you want for lunch?
Nothing.
You want nothing for lunch?
Chili dogs?
Chili dogs? What? You don't eat chili... What is that?
Sonic Advance 2.
This week's notable title from 20 years ago, Sonic Advance 2?
Yep. Developed by Dimps and published by Sega for the Game Boy Advance.
Yeah, Enid, we all know it was developed by Dimps and published by Sega for the Game Boy Advance. How are you playing it on a computer?
It's not mine.
Not yours? Don't lie to me. Where did you get this? Answer me! Who taught you how to emulate video games?
It was you, all right? I learned it by watching you.
Parents who emulate video games have children who emulate video games.
All right, so our notable title from 30 years ago is called Fire and Ice. It's a puzzle game, and it actually is a sequel to another game called Solomon's Key, and it was actually called Solomon's Key Part 2 in other regions, but not in North America. We got Fire and Ice. So as you can see, there's no fire here, but I got the ice behind me at the ice rink. I thought that would be cute. What is that noise? Bro, you're gonna talk about fire and ice and not show fire? Dumb. Oh God, not you again. What are you doing here? Wait, is that my house? Yeah, and I got tacos. Oh God, these are so good.
and so good for you.
No, those tacos are not good for you. Fine. We'll talk about fire and ice together. You'll be the fire. I'll be the ice.
Ha! Yeah! Fire. Alright, cool.
Alright, so this game is a puzzle game mixed with kind of like an adventure game. You're a wizard named Dana who is going around this island putting out fires that have been started by an evil wizard. And you use your magical ice powers to put them out.
Yo, but like, why would you want to put out fire? Fire is, like, really sick.
What do you mean? It's fire. They don't want fire all over their island. You know, they want to live normally, all right? What's so hard to understand about that?
A lot. Like, how do they cook if they don't have fire on this island? Duh. You can't make tacos without fire.
Look, I didn't say there was no fire on the island at all, okay? They clearly have fire to stay warm and things like that. They just don't want it, you know, running amok everywhere. Why are we even talking about the logic of this?
I don't know. I thought you were the one who was all, like, worried about being authentic or some dumb bullshit.
Anyway, the wizard Dana uses this ice to put out the fires that are sprung up. It's a puzzle game. Like I said, it's a puzzle game. And so you have to kind of like figure out how to move these blocks of ice to put the fire out. Some of them you have to create by using your magic wand. Some of them you have to destroy in order to make other pieces of ice fall onto the fire. And that's how you put the fire out with the ice.
Hold on. Let me get this straight. To put out the fire, you drop ice on it. But wouldn't fire just melt the ice?
Yeah, you idiot. What do you think happens to ice when it melts? It turns into water, which then puts out the fire.
Oh, okay, yeah. No, I get it. That's good. That's good. That's good. Anyway, wasn't this game called Solomon's Key Part 2?
Yeah, I went over that earlier. Were you paying attention?
No.
All right, well, anyway, the cover was kind of cool. It had, like, a warning on there. Like, hey, warning, this game is highly addictive. Because, you know, puzzle games were kind of a big deal back then with Tetris and stuff like that. So they really wanted to, like, capture that, that part of the gaming segment that had just come into console gaming with you know, Tetris. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Oh, I'm gonna eat these Girl Scout cookies.
What? Those are mine! Don't eat those! Eat your disgusting tacos!
You're not here, and they're just sitting there, so, I get to eat them now. Here we go, do-si-do, in my mouth,
You son of a bitch. Give me back my cookies.
These are really good. I guess I'm eating this whole thing because you're over there, not here.
You think I can't get over there, huh? You think I can't get over there? Just watch.
What?
The midnight train going anywhere.
Notable title from 20 years ago, Sonic Advance 2?
Yeah, published by whatever and something by Sega for the Nintendo. I remember the book.